Time is of the essence, and I'm not gonna waste it by giving you guys a long-winded intro. I wanna give you guys my unique perspective on the new Apple Watch Series 4. So let's get into it. What do you think, Mickey?
It's 108!
As an Apple exclusive, this watch has been around enough to see 4 iterations thus far, with several improvements and additions as each one is released. So let's take a look at the device and what comes in the box. If you're planning on getting this as a stocking stuffer for this upcoming holiday season, you might need a bigger stocking. The elongated box is not hard to open up initially, and we're presented with some startup documents, the magnetic watch charger, the watch face covered in a velvet soft cover, the power adapter, and finally the watch straps. One thing to note is that there is a small watch strap and a medium slash large watch strap included with this watch to fit any wrist size. The one that we purchased is the 40mm space gray aluminum version with the standard black sports band. It came out to the base rate of 519 Canadian plus tax. Apple offers the new Series 4 in both 40mm and 44mm. Now, some of you may think that this watch looks like a toy, and that's a warranted opinion. When the watch was first released years ago, I actually thought the exact same thing. But its appearance and functionality has caused me to overlook that, and that initial mindset has subsided, at least for myself. It's not an eyesore, and its screen actually makes up for the design, as it's gorgeous. The new rounded corner-to-corner OLED display allows you to see more information at a glance, and the placement of data on every watch face has been meticulously thought out. But I would love for Apple to design a circular watch face at some point, and I feel like they will. It's eventually going to be some big reveal during an Apple event, followed by applause and cheers as if Apple invented this all-new round watch face for the very first time. I can guarantee it. There are a couple of design differences with this Series 4 compared to last year's offering. Looking around the watch, we have the speaker grille on the left-hand side, which I should say is incredibly loud. We also have the side button flush with the casing on the right-hand side. This is used to bring up your recent apps, and double tapping it will bring up Apple Pay. Above that, we have the microphone for Siri and phone calls, and finally, at the very top, is the digital crown, which is extremely responsive and provides a subtle haptic feedback when navigating through the OS. Now, let's talk about that for a minute. The Watch OS 5 is probably my favorite smartwatch interface to date. It's extremely fluid and easy to get anything I need. Changing the watch face is as easy as swiping back and forth. Swiping up reveals your quick toggles, and swiping down shows you all your notifications. From the watch face, pressing once on the digital crown reveals all the apps that are available to you. I really thought I would have a lot of accidental touches here since the icons are so small, but almost every time I was able to launch the app I wanted without any issue. Holding down the digital crown will bring up Siri, and I did mention in our iPhone review that Siri is much improved in the new iOS 12 and Watch OS 5. I found myself using her a lot for bringing up relevant information. You can also summon Siri by just lifting the watch up and saying, "Hey Siri." I also noticed that the Raise to Speak feature is much more responsive in this iteration than it was in the Series 3. As well, calls were much clearer when talking to the person on the other end. It's probably due to the better mic placement on this watch. Lastly, double tapping the crown will bring up your most recent app. I honestly have not seen anything more intuitive than this. I mean, my Gear S3 watch was not that hard to navigate through, but I think the Apple Watch has a bit of an edge over that. One of my favorite features on this watch is the camera remote app. It works really well for those who want to take a picture with a selfie stick, or if you want to take a group picture from a tripod. I also have access to all my home devices from HomeKit, which is easily enabled on the watch or by asking Siri. For example, while driving, I just lifted the wrist to my face and asked Siri to turn up the heat so my place is nice and warm upon arrival. Okay, so let's talk about the display. It's gorgeous. And just like the iPhones, I didn't really need to keep the brightness at maximum in order to enjoy it. Even in well-lit conditions outside, the middle setting was nice and vibrant, and I could easily read notifications at a glance. Indoors, I had it at minimum brightness, and it was also perfectly fine. you really only have three brightness settings to choose from, and having it at max is perfectly fine if you charge your phone every night. Okay, which leads me to battery life. With the display setting in the middle, this watch lasted me a full day and night and ended up getting to about 20% closer to the evening of the next day. That's definitely not bad at all. It's really no competition to my Gear S3's battery life or even the new Galaxy Watch, but if you're in the Apple ecosystem, you wouldn't want to use those watches anyway. The experience is crippled and really not the same compared to using it on an Android device. I would love to see sleep tracking added in the future, like the Galaxy Watch already has. So when I look at a smartwatch, health and fitness is the first and foremost for me personally. I initially wanted an activity tracker on my wrist, but having all the extra apps and features from the Series 4 is great as well. I've been through my share of Wear OS watches, Fitbit, and even a Garmin tracker. They all have their pros and cons, but I feel like Apple has done a fantastic job when it comes to health tracking. Samsung is probably my next favorite when it comes to this. The Apple Health app offers so much data to keep you motivated and informed about your overall well-being. And it seems like it's only getting better. The heart tracking features were already pretty accurate, and I feel like it has something to do with the protruding sensors on the bottom. My Gear S3 is fairly accurate, but I feel like it sometimes doesn't get the right heart rate, as it's not always touching my skin. Whatever the case, I love the features on this watch, and like my Gear S3, it has automatic workout detection. I don't always have to worry about setting it before I hit the weights or heading out for a run. Water resistance is standard on most watches these days, and the Apple Watch is no different. Apple even says that showering with the Series 2 and up is okay. Just keep it away from any soaps or shampoos. Swimming is also possible with this watch, and the Series 2 and later all have water resistance ratings up to 50 meters. The ECG feature is an interesting addition on this watch, but I can't really speak to it at the moment on how well it works. I also did see an article on how this could cause a false sense of risk among users and lead people to do unneeded tests based on false positives. It's not available in Canada at the moment. Should be coming to the US soon, but don't know when it'll come to us. There's also fall detection on this new watch, but I could never trigger it, even when I tried. What I want you to know though is, don't let this be a deciding factor when it comes to buying the Apple Watch Series 4. If you don't need the latest and greatest, the Apple Watch Series 3 will be perfectly fine if you need all those fitness capabilities and mostly everything else. And you'll also get the same OS version with that watch. One last thing to note, the ability to play music from my watch or my phone is nothing new, but I did notice something different since the last time I used the Apple Watch. When playing a song on my phone, raising the watch will now give you immediate controls to the music app, so you don't have to swipe to change songs. I like that. Overall, this watch is the perfect companion to complement your iPhone. There are still people who haven't really bought into the whole smartwatch craze, and probably never will. That's perfectly fine. But for those of you who are looking for an easy way to get access to your phone without having to pull it out every time, or even having it within reach, the Apple Watch Series 4 is the watch to have. It's highly useful in various scenarios, such as paying without pulling out your wallet or phone, glancing at notifications, tracking your workouts, or even making calls from your wrist. I would recommend this watch for anyone who owns an iPhone, but again, if you don't care for stuff like the ECG feature, which will eventually come, or minor improvements to the overall design of the watch, maybe look into getting the Series 3. It will be cheaper, and you'll pretty much get the same kind of experience. I do wish it had an always-on display, as well as sleep tracking features, but this may come down the line. So if those things are important to you, it's probably best to wait. I hope this review has been informative for you guys. If you like this video, please go ahead and give it a thumbs up. And if you never want to miss another video again, don't forget to hit that subscribe button as well as the bell notification for all our upcoming reviews and how-tos. Check out that Patreon link down in the description below. Your support, whether you subscribe, view our videos, or even donate, means the world to us. Let us know your thoughts on the Apple Watch, and if you already own one, what's your favorite feature? Like always, I'm Jared the TechVenger. Don't forget, when it comes to tech, the TechVengers are there. We got your back.